Boom! Jeremy, Jeremy, Jeremy.
Matthew!
What's up, man?
Howdy.
Dude, we did pretty good on the podcast.
We did. It's our third live one.
Yeah.
Episode 22.
Episode
22. And now, if you're watching this, you're watching the, what was I saying, aftercast.
The aftercast. And I totally faded that music like super fast. I gotta get better at it. Ben's no longer here, so.
After the cast.
But yeah, man. So
that's fun. We had people in our chat room, which made me feel so special.
Yeah. That was Jeremy's first time to see people in the chat.
Yeah. And it was Jeremy's second time out of the three times to know we were live.
Oh, yeah. That's true, too.
We did like our second live one. Like, I'm just doing it, thinking that we're just recording like we're doing here. Because when we record these, Matt can edit it so he can make something appear or whatever.
Right.
You know, and make it pretty.
But if you ever want to watch us live, just hit the bell. We don't put out a lot of videos, so you don't have to worry about spam.
Let's do it like everybody's like, make sure you hit the bell and you'll be notified whenever we go live or post a new video on YouTube.
That's it. Make sure to like and subscribe and blah, 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 blah.
That's what they do on WatchMojo, all of them, and it's so funny.
Dude, it's almost annoying.
It is, but I mean, we do want them, though. We do like the bell.
Yeah.
I just think whenever we hit the bell, it would sing Donna Summer's, wanna ring my bell.
Oh, yeah? I was thinking Hell's ring Bells by AC/DC.
Or Jingle Bells.
All right. Yep, you win. Jingle Bells.
My friend put up her tree this week, her Christmas tree. I swear to chickens.
No,
did.
I believe it.
And then she just posted. She's like, yeah, I did it. I don't care what you have to say. She's been wanting it. Somewhere.
Yeah.
She's one of those. See, I can't listen to Christmas music year-round. It makes me sad.
I can't do it either.
But November 1st, you know.
Yep. When Jeremy, so, yeah. He gets ready. Y'all were going to see
going,
Jeremy.
So just wanted to let you know that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Appreciate it, man. But Jeremy will absolutely get to this point right here. Around October-ish, he's just kind of, he's ready. But then November through December and almost all the way up to the New Year's,
I lose it.
It's a different person.
I am. I already warned Billy. I told Billy, I was like, hey, just let you know, probably gonna be freaking out during the holidays. And he's like, okay. No, I'm like, no, seriously. Like, I'm going to be like a different person.
Yeah, he has no idea what's coming, does he?
He doesn't know what's coming.
Oh, man.
He's going to be sick of it. He's going to be like, I'll talk to you January 1. I'll kiss you at midnight with us the last time
that's
I'll see
it.
You.
He's like, look, you can get this.
Yeah.
He doesn't know. But Jeremy's got the spirit, but you got something for us.
I do. I was just, remember the time I heard it today on something, and they call it appointment TV.
Huh.
You remember back in the day when you used to have to rush home to watch something
because
we didn't have DVRs.
Mm-hmm.
So what was some appointment TV that you had? And I love the name appointment TV. This just makes it cool. Like you had to make an appointment, like come 6 o'clock, boom, you know, I have to watch it.
I did.
Live.
I did watch a few of the first American Idols.
Okay. And yep. That was before DVR.
And then Family Guy.
Okay.
When
see
they,
that.
Because they finally came back on. And then they showed a lot of reruns. What was I saying?
That's us.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Can't DVR us that.
Whose line is it anyway?
Oh, okay.
Was another one. What's yours?
Let's
hear it.
Days of Our Lives.
Uh-oh.
I love Days of Our Lives. There's a scene in, like, hopefully, and I know you hate when I ask to put up videos, but maybe put up a video. But, like, there's when Marlena was possessed by the devil,
because
she got possessed by Satan or something, I freaked out. That's when I first started watching it.
Yeah.
My mom used to watch Guiding Light and some other soap operas.
So where do you want the video? Right here?
Here.
What do you mean the devil?
Stop hiding behind her. I'm talking to you.
No. No.
No! Clever Francis. But you're too late to save her.
You know, like show her levitating out of bed or something like that and everything. Because what happened was there's this character, Stefano, he would come in the middle of the night and like do stuff to her, like hypnotize her.
Yeah.
Well, when he did that, he was opening her soul up, and then the devil creeped in, and she's all like floating, and like it was just crazy. I mean, it was so campy and over the top.
Yeah.
But like, I would either like I'd call my mom from school to be like, and she had to work my mom, like teach my mom how to do the video. I'm like, Mom, put in the tape and you hit record, you know, and so either she had to record it for me and I'd watch it when I got home. And, but yeah, I remember like back in the day you'd record stuff and you'd record over other people's stuff and they'd be pissed.
South Park.
I hate South Park.
Back in 1999. You don't like South Park at all?
No, I can't stand their voices. I just don't find,
Did you ever like them?
I'm the kind of person, cause I love to laugh. I try to find humor in anything.
Yeah.
They get on my fucking nerves. They really do.
So it's more the voices.
It's just, I don't know. I feel like they try too hard.
Really?
I don't know. Like I like when things happen. And again, I watch raunchy stuff. Like, if you watch Big Mouth on Netflix, it's a homework assignment. It's like 30-minute episodes. It's hilarious. It's a cartoon. It's about these kids going through puberty. There's a hormone monster on there.
Which is hilarious.
There's a pillow that gets pregnant. That's my favorite episode.
Yeah.
And because he like winds up humping his pillow and she winds up having a baby. And he's like, what am I going to do? I don't want to be a daddy at 12.
This is a feather baby.
It is over the top. And you'll probably know all the comedians in there. I promise you. Because you're really good in the comedic world. Like, mm-hmm. you know. And, but yeah, I don't know. I mean, again, I respect all kind of humor and all, but it just, anyway.
Yeah, it's not your cup of tea. Yeah, man. I get that. But that was one of the shows back when it kind of first started. And what's funny is I can remember going back and or watching that tape over and over and over. And I remember Jon Stewart, and he was doing a promo for his show because
he was on Comedy Central. Him and South Park were sort of like the foundation of Comedy Central.
That's it. Yep. I remember when they were putting out like trailers saying, you know, the Daily Coming Show soon. Is starting.
Yeah.
And this is the start of it. Now he's retired and gone. And anyway. You know how it is, dude.
Yeah, like Smallville was my favorite back in the day, Smallville.
Yeah.
And I hated if I ever overslept on a Saturday morning, I'd miss my Saturday morning cartoons. Mm-hmm. I was a grouch the rest of the day. If I missed my Saved by the Bell, because I wanted to watch it then. Because, again, if you missed it, it was gone. There was no other way to watch it, if you think about it.
Yeah.
They didn't put things on video.
No.
They didn't DVR it. So if you watch, you missed it.
Yeah, you missed it. You had to read about it. And then you had to go to work or school the next day. Yeah. Did you see it? No, I missed it. Tell me what happened.
It was gone.
Well, this is it. It's gone.
I was pissed if I missed it. I mean, because you know TV is like everything, so.
Yeah, and Be Kind, Please Rewind.
Oh, my gosh. I just remember, like, it's just so many things that I'm getting to the age where I'm like, these young people don't understand. But the Friday nights going to Blockbuster and reading the back of the it was so much fun to me.
It was really fun. I always rented Three Ninjas. The Three Ninjas. Do you remember that?
Yes. Tum Tum.
Tum Tum. Yeah. Rocky and Colt.
Tum Tum and Colt.
Yes.
And then they made a sequel because I think Hulk Hogan was in the sequel.
Or was he? Oh, Back in Action.
Back in Action.
Strike. Something.
God, Three Ninjas was so good.
I like Three Ninjas. Tum Tum.
Oh, my gosh.
Man.
I remember when I first got the original, because, you know, the original Superman and Goonies are my two favorite, you know, as a child. Mm-hmm. When I remember just getting them, and I was like, you mean I could just watch it over and over again? Like, I suppose I didn't wear out the video. And then, like, when they started putting Disney stuff on VHS, I was like, what?
Yeah.
Like, it was a big thing. Like, yeah.
And I don't know why my mom didn't just buy me the Three Ninjas movie. Because as many times as we rented it, I was like, every time we go, can we get Three Ninjas again? And we always had to return it.
And kids' rentals were normally like 99 cents or free. Like, you know, like on certain days, they'd be like free kids. Because that way, if you got an adult movie, but you know what I mean?
Right, yeah.
Remember when like adult movies, like, oh my God. I remember at our local one, like there was a door or like had like a curtain or something.
We didn't have that in our hometown.
And so I never understood why people would go in there. Like I was just like, and then like somebody would go in there. I'm like, what's behind there? You know? And like, you can't go in there. I'm like, okay. So they had like a regular DVD store and then they had that. And remember you used to get charged $1 if you, didn't rewind it.
Yeah, freaking rewind. You didn't rewind.
So when they were like, be kind, rewind, they wasn't lying.
No, they're like, look, be kind.
Rewind, or we can charge you behind. Ooh, that's all rhymes.
Hey, look at that.
Hey, in time.
But I remember the first time that I turned 18 years old, and I could go to Fantasyland. I was in high school.
Is that like the dirty movie place?
And it was in Tuscaloosa. And one of my buddies was already 18, and then two of my buddies there? Wasn't. I have no idea. I doubt. I'm sure internet has put them out of business by now. Yeah. But back then, you had to go. Well, I had all these like younger people and everything. Everybody from the football team was giving me money. They're like, "Can you give me DVDs?" And blah blah blah. Oh, I would take $5 off the top. I was like, "Yeah." So they would give
you
me
your own little business.
And they're like, "Just give me any porno. It doesn't matter."
Any.
So I went to like the clearance section and was like, "So I ended up making money." But dude, I remember walking in. They had the little butt thing flopped over in the corner. And my buddy Chad says that a guy walks in, he goes, "Oh, I thought this used to be a old warehouse thing. Well, I guess since I'm here, I'll look around." Because, like, dude, it was weird. Like, you didn't want your car in the parking lot. You would park down the road.
Exactly. You would never, but you didn't want people to see you.
But when I was 18, I pulled up right in the first spot. I was like, boom. They're like, "Can I see your ID?" I'm like, "Yes, ma'am.
Bam.
Today is my birthday. Time for me to jack off like an adult."
It's like before, like 21, like, you know, 21, you're ready to drink. 18, you're ready to.
Yeah.
I'm ready to go to the porn store.
You know what's crazy is I was having sex even before that.
But it was something about watching porn, though.
It was like I couldn't do it, but now. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But, you know, down in Florida, you can buy like cigarettes and stuff at 18.
Really?
In Mississippi, you can do that. But in Alabama, you got to be 19.
Hmm.
Yeah. I didn't know that.
My mom, I've never bought my mom cigarettes.
Oh, no. I'm not a big smoker.
But, I mean, it was just the thing about my mom knew, because that was back when I used to go to church and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
She just knew, like, she'd ask my brother, anybody else, but she just knew for me, I would never, ever buy her, you know. Thankfully, I'm so glad my mom quit smoking. After 30 years, she quit on her own, but.
That's awesome. After 30 years, dude.
30 years. Like, because my whole life she smoked.
And she just cold turkeyed it?
Yeah. She was having some kind of surgery, and she cold turkeyed it, and she has not picked that up. She did have, she cut, like, straws.
It's all mental, isn't it?
Yeah, because she held straws in her hand,
because
it was. And she did the suckers, you know, that kind of thing. But, yeah, I was so proud of her because it helped her so much.
That's awesome.
But what's crazy is it took so long. Like, when I moved out, I smelt it. Because then when you live in it, you don't realize it.
You're right.
So, but as soon as I moved out, my clothes, after a few days, I was like, "What is that smell?" I mean, I went through bottles of Febreze because it just attaches itself to it. You know what I mean?
It's in the fiber of your clothes.
Yes, you just don't know. Because I remember when I used to go to church and school, people were like, they always thought I smoked. But it was just because, you know, my parents smoked.
Let me tell you a weird story is that, and this might cut off in a second, so just keep an eye on it. But the one time, like, I had a buddy. And you don't really see this on the opposite.
You spoke it, and it happened.
Yeah. You don't actually see this on the opposite sex. And what I mean by that is, like, a lot
on
of times,
the opposite sex.
Like, women are more clean than guys. Well, I would go over to his dad's house, and how given it could have been his stepmom that kept the house clean and all this good stuff, but I would go over to his mom's house, who wasn't remarried, and she had these big German Shepherd dogs, dude. And...
It smelled?
Jeremy, no.
Did she smoke too?
Jeremy.
I love when you get serious.
It was so bad, dude.
I love when you did that.
Like, imagine, like, but when you walk in, it makes you not want to be in that house.
Yeah.
And there was just stuff in the sink, and, like, I was like, "Hey, you got any water?" Blah, blah. Yeah, but
you didn't even want to get it.
I didn't really want to do it, but he had a fine sister.
Oh, my God.
And there'd be dog poop, like, just in the room.
Stop.
I promise, man. And, like, they weren't, like, crazy about it. And then he got mad at me one day for trying to, like, he's like, "No, you can just go in there and talk to her." Because that was really on the
reason
why I was there. I was trying to talk to her. I was in the sixth grade. I know exactly what grade I was in. I stayed the night. And I used to stay over there a lot, but I never stayed on a school night. I finally stayed on a school night. I went to school, and when I got to school, my clothes smelled like his house. And I called my mom to check me out of school.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And I never knew why he wasn't more self-conscious of it.
Yeah, because he didn't know.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't know. You don't know at all.
And it's, I don't know. And I remember talking to... A girl that dated him later, you know, later on. And I said, and I'm sure it's not the case anymore, but when I was a kid or younger, I was in college, I think, when I talked to this girl. I said, "His mom's always house smelled like really bad." She goes, "No, it's so bad." I'm like, "Still? Oh my God." But it was so bad, Jeremy. Like, when you talk about it getting in your clothes, I checked out of school.
Yeah.
Because my shirt stunk.
It's so bad. And probably until he went to school or college and moved out, Like, you know what I mean? You probably honestly did not know till then. Because it just happened.
Yeah.
It just happens.
It just happens.
You don't even realize it at all.
Yeah.
That's happened to me, so.
But yeah, man. But I know you got a gut. You got
a gut. I get a gig. Supposedly had a good rap podcast album coming
out. We did. But y'all go check out the podcast and also check us out on Instagram.
Instagram, Matt's posting these amazing little clips, a little nuggets. That's what I like. You know, my favorite word with some sauce, some nuggets. And on Instagram. And then, like I said, like us on, like, touch the bell. Ting, and
yeah,
you'll be notified.
Oh, and if y'all want to, and it's totally not a big deal, because if you're watching this on YouTube, I'm sure you're only on YouTube because it's Aftercast. But if you do happen to listen to the podcast anywhere other than YouTube, if you want to give us a 5-star rating or a 4-star, or at least rate the podcast, that would be
on
super
iTunes.
Cool. Yeah, on iTunes, on Google, anywhere, Stitcher, that actually gets us up
it's
in the
awesome.
Ranking. But
battery's going down. On
totally
this
up to y'all. Appreciate y'all watching, guys, and we will see y'all when Jeremy.
Next week.
That's it.
Y'all come back now. You here?
You here? All right. Thanks, guys.
Bye.